Hello students, I believe that all of you are safe and keeping in a good health. My dear students of semester 2, I believe that you are really keeping well and studying also. Are you? Okay. Today we are going to discuss the functions of communication and mass communication. As we were discussing communication, we have seen that the communication has got three basic functions. One is the information, second is the education, and third is the entertainment. So these three objectives that what communication do, that is the informing the people, so this is giving information, and educating the people through information, and then entertaining the people, because entertainment is a very important part in case of communication. And now that we should see that what are the actual functions, what the mass communication do. Because whenever we talk about communication, we have to remember that communication is intrapersonal, interpersonal, and then group, and then mass communication. Now, whenever we are discussing the intrapersonal, interpersonal, and group communication, it is easier to say that this kind of communication, they inform the people, they help in interaction, inform the people, and then they try to educate the people. As for example, you know that people are talking to each other and getting information, or maybe a teacher teaching in the class, so that is one kind of a giving education. And entertainment, you can see that a lot of entertainment, a person reading a book is entertainment, two friends chatting are entertainment, a group of people watching a movie is an entertainment. So in this case, it is easier to find out what this kind of communications are doing. But when it is mass communication, it is very important to find out what are the functions of mass communication. Now, as you know, that mass communication is a part of communication. So this information, education, and entertainment, all these three should be there. Along with it, there are other functions too. So first of all, we can say the surveillance. What is the surveillance function of mass communication? Surveillance is that the people who are working for the media, because you know, whenever we talk about mass communication, mass media is a part of it. Without mass media, there can be no mass communication. So the people who are working in mass media, they always go to some places, whenever they gather the information and they disseminate the information, they keep an observation on the whole thing. They keep a surveillance on the whole thing. So that means they observe the thing, they find out the thing which is right or wrong, and they prepare it with whatever is correct for the people, and then they only disseminate it. So this is the surveillance function. That means the media people, they are keeping a surveillance on the whole thing of whatever events are taking place. The second is correlation. Correlation is that it is actually a lot of things are happening in this world, and the media people are correlating the matters with it. With us. How are they correlating? That is, they are, if you go back to the newspaper. In the newspaper, what used to be happen, that the people, they used to collect information, that means the reporter, they used to collect information, then they used to judge, and then after that, they used to interpret the matter. It was not only the objectivity, but at the same time, the interpretation. After interpreting, then they used to write the news. Same thing was happening for the electronic media. For the electronic media also, people were gathering information, and whenever the people are reading on radio and television, the news readers, they are also given those news which are written after the interpretation. So this is the correlating function of the media. Media correlates the matter with us. Now that if we see the social media, we see this correlation is absent, because there is no intermediary person. the producer is given the information, whoever is the producer, and the others are the consumers, they're getting it. So there is nobody to find out whether it is right or to interpret, to correlate the matter. So this, the mass media, they always correlate and then only they disseminate the information. The next is the transmission. Transmission, as you all know, that in the media, in the mass media, without transmission, nothing can go. Like especially for the electronic media, especially for radio and television, the signals are necessary to be transmitted, and this go to different people. I mean, through the machines, it go to people, and then people get the information. So, unless the media people gather information and prepare it and they transmit it properly, we are not getting the information. So the mass media has got the function to transmit the matter, and through transmission we get information from the media. The next is the entertainment. The entertainment is why we talk about entertainment again, because we have found out that throughout the world, entertainment is the biggest factor, especially for the electronic media. People are interested in information, they love to get education, but at the same time, the majority of the people, they are mostly interested in entertainment. So that is the reason the majority part of the electronic media is filled up with entertainment. Now this is the function of the mass media to entertain the people in different way. Entertainment doesn't always mean it is something related to the movie or maybe games or maybe a reality show. Not that. Entertainment could be a good discussion also. For different people, entertainment has got different definitions. So if for the some scholarly people, a good discussion is an entertainment. Maybe for the majority of people who are the sports lover, a game or a sports or any kind of a show related to game, that is entertainment. For the people who love the movie, to them the movie is an entertainment. So there are several kinds of entertainment, and nowadays we see the reality shows, the chat shows, all these things also try to, through all these things, the media people try to entertain the people. Then comes the validation. That is another important function of mass communication. Validation is that whenever we see some program on television, there are some, maybe it's a news, maybe it's a different program, there are some characters. Those characters, they belong to a particular caste or a creed or a group, and the media actually validate those things in such a manner that the media gives a kind of a sign that one particular group is meant to do such things. Say for example, like we often see that media always try to promote some group, those group who are the higher class of the people or the higher caste, that they always do the better things for the society, the good things, etc. And quote unquote, that there are some groups, especially some kind of a minorities, we see also that media sometime promote some program in such a manner, they validate that this particular group is meant to do some kind of a, maybe we should not say crime, maybe some kind of a menial kind of a work. So this is some kind of a validation that media always do for us. And the common people, they have got a standard belief that this particular group can do this kind of a thing, the others cannot. So these are done by the media. And finally, another thing is the mobilization. Mobilization is, we can call it a persuasion also, because through transmission, media try to persuade the people, try to create an impact on the people. And this mobilization means it's mobilizing a big group, the mass, to do something. Say for example, right now, the situation we are living in, we know that not only the crisis from the disease, the COVID-19, we are also facing a lot of crisis from the economic side, the financial side. So what media is doing, media is trying to mobilize the people to do something for the poor class, to do something for the have-nots. So then the people are coming together. They are, you know, either they are paying in cash or in kind. They are trying to help the people. So this is something, the mobilizing the people, bringing them together so that they can do some work for the society. So these are all the functions for mass communication. So well, keep well and stay safe, stay at home, but study well. This is the video I have done in English because, you know, in our same two class, there are some people who do not follow Bengali. But again, I'll do the same video and I'll speak in Bengali so that the students who are studying in the Bengali medium, they can understand that. Okay then, bye.